It's a show where's a
Grapple
wig.
Oh, Grapple McGuartnash, I'm David Bellamy. Oh, you mean Bruce Forsyth?
Yeah.
Can't do him.
Oh, Pet. Oh, hang on. Oh, the Violet Blade. Mm.
Do you think he's up to it?
Well, he didn't ask for any money.
Sign him up. We've got our Barry replacement.
Hey!
Can anyone replace our hugely hipped hero? Will the Violet Blade step into Barry's showbiz shoes? All will be revealed when BTV, that's Pirate TV, continues. Welcome home to BTV, where Barry has lost his voice, and the Violet Blade is about to replace him. What a turn of events. Stay tuned as the story concludes.
Right, I've got him on the radio and he says he'll be docking in half an hour.
And he definitely confirmed he'd be doing it for free.
Well, no, not exactly. Hang on. Oh, for a flag and a rum and a casket of ale. All right.
Well, I better be going down the off licence then. What about him?
Sado's making him an artificial voice.
Well, if his real voice doesn't come back, we'll have to be looking for a permanent replacement.
We'll see, shall we?
Anyway, I think you'd better be writing Violet Blade's script.
Right. I'll just watch Ask the Vidiators and get a feel for his character, okay?
Good.
Hey, Electric Eddie, you're letting that Trixie Bellmaker follow him. You're being beaten by a girl.
Got a question?
No, I just wanted to give you some abuse.
Look, I don't need to come here to get abuse. I can get abuse anywhere. Here's some Mega Drive June 2 passwords, whether you like them or not. Power Crush takes you to level 9 on Harkonnen. Meanwhile, Death Ruler takes you to level 9 on Ordos.
Acknowledge.
There you go. I'm the king and queen of all cheats. What is it? What's the joke? What are you laughing at?
Ah, Barry, me old mucker. Heard you in a bit of bother, eh? Sorry, forgot you couldn't answer me back.
Go away, you big girl's blouse.
Well, Violet's being good to you.
This is my show.
Stop
my
that, you
show.
Silly old woman.
Hey, you, watch it. Now listen, we're going to go and talk to the researchers, all right?
Researchers, eh? Where'd you keep them? Shackled up in the brick, eh?
Don't worry about you sometimes.
Excuse me. It's not right, is it? Salty old seaman like that presenting your show. I tell you what is good, though. The gadget of the week.
What is it?
Just use the force. I think that's the best idea. Okay. Ta-da.
Now, Mr. Blade, if it's the reviewers you want, press F9.
Yeah.
And GR.
GR.
And enter.
Enter.
There you go.
I've never used a commuter before. Oh, there they are.
Right, big review time now, and we've got Micro Machines 2. Remember that, Barry, the game you went to see in the summer? Right, it's finally made it onto Mega Drive, and it's got J-Cart, and it's exactly the same as the first one. You hardly got any enhancements here. You got a couple more cars, you got a couple more levels. Plus, you can play as Jeremy Daldry, and you can also play as some little dwarf called Violet, or I don't know who she is. Spike.
Well, I mean, this game is a rarity on two counts. First, it actually is better than the original, no matter what he says. And secondly, they have enhanced it massively. It's full of lots of things the original didn't have. The sound is much better, the graphics are good, with the special tiny dwarf mode, maybe that's for Violet. And you've got a lot of extra courses in there, and the whole thing hangs together really, really well. I like this one. It's got good old-fashioned gameplay. Salo!
There's several little icing-on-the-cake features which I really enjoyed about this game. Up to 8 players can take part in the league option. There's 27 different courses, but it's random as to which one comes up each time you play. And one final feature, by pressing the C button, you can honk your horn.
I'm sorry I'm in a grumpy mood today, I just don't like any of the games we've looked at. I'm going to give this one 6 out of 10.
Well, that's none of those high-tech polygons, there's no video sequences, just gameplay, that's what you want. I'll give it 9 out of 10.
Yeah, 8 out of 10.
Thanks, me fellows. That was most fine. The flags are running, the stuffed pigs are on me. Aha!
Aha!
Ah, here we are. Now, this is a script to prepare for you, Mr. Blade.
Script? No thanks, darling. I'll do it by the seat of my pants or not at all.
Oh, well, if you think you can manage that.
Yeah.
Violet Blade to office.
Okay, I think that's me.
Right.
Deep breath, off you go.
Where am I going?
Over there. Oh, God, I hope he makes it.
Oh, Barry, this TV presenting's a lot of fun. What's next for me, eh?
Now the work will begin. Sit and watch my feature.
I could get used to this.
I'm at the computer exchange in London, where they've got the Sega Saturn and the first ever Sony PlayStation in the country. The trouble is, they're not yet on sale to the public. They're not even on sale to me. I needed a peek at the new systems. Unfortunately, I had a cunning plan.
The name's Large. Larry Large.
First thing I want you to do before it gets busy is to put the games on the shelves.
Do what? This isn't what I came here for.
Come downstairs with me, big boy. I've got something to show you.
Don't do that. Salo.
The Sega Saturn was released 2 weeks ago in Japan. It's a CD-based machine using two 32-bit processors at a combined speed of 56 MIPS. Its sprite handling is astonishing, as are its Yamaha sound processing capabilities. Expected UK release date is next December.
No, folks, this isn't the arcade. You're actually looking at the first shots of Virtual Fighter on the Sega Saturn. The game is virtually arcade perfect, except this one runs a little smoother and the sound is a little better. Personally, I think it's big boy brilliant and will help shift a hell of a lot of Saturns. This is Gal Racer running on the Saturn. It's actually a conversion of the smash hit Ragmobile. It's good, but it could have been a heck of a lot better. The 3D doesn't reach far enough into the distance, which makes it confusing to see just what's going on. Better luck next time, Sega.
The Sony PlayStation was released 10 days ago in Japan. It's the most powerful console in existence, with 3D handling and texture mapping second to none. Its single 32-bit RISC chip runs at an incredible 500,000 polygons per second.
Well, I don't know what you guys think, but I personally think the graphics are absolutely arcade perfect.
It's just really smooth. I've never seen anything like this. It's great.
Now, this is Konami's first offering for the PlayStation. It's a straight convert of their Proteus 2 arcade. I think it's arcade perfect and I love it loads. Adrian, what do you think?
No, I didn't like that game, Barry. Weak graphics, poor gameplay. This one you want to avoid.
Now, this is one of the first batch of PlayStation titles. It's a nameless techno-soft beat-em-up. It's two-player at once. It's kind of like Final Fight. Tim, what do you think?
I don't like it that much, really, because I think it's a bit slow. I think it's a bit dull. I think it could do much better.
Not too bad. I could have probably done better myself, but...
Listen, I'm off for a pizza or three.
Yeah. Okay.
I need the whole thing cut up by 10, okay?
Barnacles. Smedley.
Yeah, hello.
I've got an important appointment with your probation officer. Mm-hmm. I wonder if you could help me out here. Tell Barry I'm sorry, but I'm gonna have to go.
It don't matter, I think we've got Roland from Grange Hill. Apparently he's not too busy these days, yeah.
Fair enough.
Oh, what's going on here?
Aha!
Could you keep it down, please?
Thank you.
Oh! Hello, games mistress!
Yes!
I was wondering if you'd like to come over and do the show.
You forget I'm 12,000 miles away and you're on air in just a few minutes. Sorry, darling, but it has to be no.
Oh, well, please yourself.
Hello again, my darling Fluffkins. People have been leaving cheat request messages for me by the truckload, and I've got mountains to look at. Let's see who slipped in first, shall we, though?
I'm turning the bird in. I'm high in the sky, but I want to go further. Help me out, bounciest babe.
I assume that's a roundabout way of asking for a password for turn and burn on the snares. Here goes, then. Enter TDLJGSHX. That gets you to level 16, which is the very last level. There's about 7 billion more messages still to be answered, but a girl's gotta get out and see the world a bit. I'm off to the Bahamas now, but I'll be back next week. Same time, same place, same rubber dress. Ciao.